Can we just close our eyes 1 minute? As you close your eyes, try to remember things that we have spoken about in the past few months. Try to remember things you've heard in the past few months. Praise God. Is there something that you do not understand? Is there something troubling you? Is there a blockage somewhere in your growth, in your flow, in the things of God? I will say, listen again, silently, as your Father speaks to you. Your Father is speaking to you always. Your Father is speaking to you always, always, always. And He wants you to come to the knowledge of the truth. Praise God. This is the day of grace. This is the day of your deliverance. This is the day of your power. This is the day of your glory. So receive what the Spirit is saying to the church in this hour. Father, thank you. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise God, praise God, praise God.
Oh, yeah.
The book of Proverbs, can we turn there fast? The book of Proverbs chapter 20. Proverbs chapter 20 from verse 12. The hearing ear and the seeing eye, the Lord has made even both of them. Then he goes on in verse 13 to say, love not sleep, lest thou come to poverty. Open thy eyes and thou shalt be satisfied with bread. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So he says, he starts off by saying that the hearing ear and the seeing eye, God has made them both. Then he says that you should not love sleep, otherwise poverty will come unto you. Open your eyes and you'll be satisfied with bread. Like I've always said, the Bible is a double-edged sword. You can apply this Bible in two ways. You can apply it carnally and spiritually. And they're both profitable. But there's one that is profitable unto all things and eternally. And that is when you interpret it spiritually. You know it very clearly that if you like sleep as a young man, if while your mates are studying, while your mates are going out to work, to look for a job, and you're at home sleeping, you know what your end will be like. Your end will be a miserable end, generally speaking. Of course, there are some exceptions. There are some exceptions to the rule, but generally speaking, the man that likes sleep will not make it. That is speaking about a lazy man. You know, in a parable, Jesus Christ called the sleeping man, the man who loves sleep, a slothful man, which is also a wicked man. You know why? You know why he's wicked? A slothful man is wicked? I will explain to you as we go further. So he says, love not sleep, lest poverty comes upon you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Open your eyes and you'll be satisfied with bread. Let us go spiritual, brethren. Because when you know the spiritual things of God, it covers everything. Praise God. The seeing eye and the hearing ear is the eye that is able to see and perceive what God is saying.
Praise God.
And we are assured that as we see and perceive what God is saying, it cannot be but good in your life all the way. Praise God. Every problem man has today is because man stopped listening. Man became deaf. Man became blind. What you see in the Bible, Jesus Christ healing the blind and healing the deaf people, he's speaking about how opening the eyes of the blind and the deaf brings about life. This is the work of the ministry, to open your spiritual eyes and your ears to see and hear once more. And you know, when you see and you hear, you become once more consciously aware of a presence that has never left you and can never leave you. That is all you need. That is what every man here needs, praise God.
Hallelujah.
That presence, to be in his presence, to be in him. When you say in his presence, that means you are in him. You are in the bosom of God. You have a life in God, nested in God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So today is opening the eyes of the blind and the ears of the deaf, that they may see. And it's restoring your riches in glory.
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's talk quickly in the book of the Gospels, Luke chapter 10, verse 22. Are you there? Let's move like a train, fast train. A locomotive. What's the name of that train that goes to Rome in an hour? Freccia. Okay, let's move like that today, fast. Luke chapter 10, verse 22. Are you there?
Yes.
All things are delivered to me of my Father. No one knows who the Son is but the Father, and who the Father is but the Son, and he to whom the Son will reveal him. And he turned unto his disciples and said privately. Now this is what Jesus is saying to you. Look at you individually. As you hear these words, just know Jesus is speaking to you. Blessed are the eyes which see the things that you see, for I tell you that many prophets and kings have desired to see these things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear these things which you hear and have not heard them. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Do you know what the disciples were seeing that the old prophets like Moses did not see? Elijah did not see? Do you know what they were seeing? They were seeing the mystery of God. God is a mystery. You know what you do? You cry out and shout out to somebody in the sky. He's not there. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You shout to the skies and cry to the skies. There's nobody there. You burn incense and sacrifice your babies, your kids. Burn sacrifice to something in the sky. To appease something in the sky. There's nobody there. But the disciples had the opportunity for the first time to see the mystery of God. And he says, nobody knows the Father except the Son, and nobody knows the Son except the Father. First of all, you must see this mystery. This is what the church is all about. When we come here together to meet as brethren, what we are doing is simply exercising our eyes to see this great mystery. Because the more you see, the more you participate in it. The more you see, the more you enter into it. Praise God. That is why in the book of Revelations, I checked with you about the Alpha and the Omega. The Alpha and the Omega is not an old man in the sky. If you want to see the Alpha and the Omega, let your eyes be open. You will see him here, seated. He's a man in the heavens. A celestial man that has been before time. Praise God. And when John turned around in the book of Revelations to see, Jesus Christ told him, look, what you are about to see, write it in a book, right, and send it to the churches so that they can see this thing that you are seeing. So what John saw in the book of Revelation chapter 1 is what we are sharing today. This is the will of God. Praise God. Talking to the book of Revelation chapter 1. Let's go to verse 7 first, then we'll jump to 10. Are you there? Revelation chapter 1 verse 7. Behold, he cometh with the clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Verse 10. I was in the spirit on the Lord's day and heard behind me a great voice as of a trumpet saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. Now look, listen to what I'm saying here. What thou seest, write in a book and send it to the churches, to the seven churches. Praise God. Now I want us to understand clearly what the language, what God is trying to tell us here as brethren. God wants you to see the secret of Christ. He wants you to understand what Christ really means. Do you know up to today, people are still thinking that Jesus is separate from them? People are still thinking Jesus is a man in the sky who is coming back from there to get them. People are still thinking one day you're going to see a man called Jesus somewhere. That means you're not listening. You're not seeing what the mystery is. People think that Jesus Christ is just somebody who gives you, you know, your money and gives you your job and, you know, answers your prayer in heaven. And some people kneel down and they imagine Jesus sitting at the right hand of God in the sky. And it's interceding for them in heaven. They are praying to Jesus and Jesus is praying to God for them. Now all these are imaginations that are simply hindering you from entering into your glory. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because what God wants you to see is to see what is the secret. What is the mystery? Now it's a mystery because these are things that have been hidden from mankind. The things that we have all forgotten as men. All religions, whether Christianity or Islam or whatever, Buddha, they all think that there is some God in the sky separate somewhere from them, who is apart from them, all of them. But God says, see. When you see the Alpha and the Omega, you now begin to recognize that God is a corporate body. And you are a member of that body.
Amen.
The more you see it, all of us, we've had some very, very bad habits we carry from this world. We all fell into the flesh and we all have nasty habits that we carry from the flesh. But how do you overcome these things? How do you overcome this world? It's by seeing and seeing and seeing and seeing and hearing and seeing and seeing. And you now begin to walk in the reality.
Amen.
Of what you are seeing and what you are hearing. Amen. So when you see a brother stumble, it doesn't mean that you begin to look down on him or anything. As far as the brother has the will to go forward in the Lord. Praise God. So you can see. He wants you to see. And what you see, write it, send it to the church. God wants you to know your glorious self in him before this world was. Because when the Alpha and the Omega speaks, he speaks like a multitude. It is a many-membered body. And God did not come to make you a member of that body. God came to reveal that you are a member of that body. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
God did not come to make you a member. He came to reveal to you that you are a member of that body. You can only be absent from this reality in your mind. And when you are absent from this reality, you will die. You only suffer many unnecessary hurts. God, why have you left me? God, why have you forsaken me? This same Jesus, God says, I will never leave you. Because you are in him, you are part of him. Even in your darkest hour, even when you are in your prison house, even when the judge sentenced you for a crime you committed, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Praise God. So what we need to do is to just see. When you come to service, we are to educate each other. We are to learn of him. We now begin to recognize that we are not terrestrial bodies. When I say terrestrial, we are not carnal beings. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Do you think you are carnal? You begin to see yourself in the spirit the way you are. Because for John to see that body, John had to be taken into what? Heaven. That means into the spirit. He says, I was in the spirit on the Lord's day. And he saw this body. So you can see that this body is not a terrestrial body. It's a celestial body. You are pure spirit, pure light. When you begin to see yourself the way you are known of God, there's a transformation that occurs gradually in your life. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You hear the word growth? To be renewed in your mind. To be changed. To be transformed. Have you heard of a translation? There's a change as you begin to look and contemplate what is the mystery of Christ. You begin to know that you might have a body, a belly in this body, in this physical body, but your real self does not need food. Your true self does not need to eat. Your true self doesn't need to sleep. Your true self doesn't need to drink water. When you begin to know certain things, you begin to detach yourself from the elements of this world. Those of us who have eating habits, you know gluttony, you know it's all part of the fruit of the flesh, to be a glutton. Some people, they see a plate of food, they shake, they can't. They must finish that plate of food. Amen. Some people eat meat like lions. Praise God. You see a cold bottle of beer, you cannot resist it. Amen. Why? When you begin to see your true nature, you begin to arise above all those elementary things. And you begin to be changed. You know what I mean? Praise God. You know, to be carnally minded is death. When you are carnally minded, you cannot see that vision. Do you know what that means? When you are carnally minded, your eyes are blinded, your ears are stopped, so you cannot perceive this body of Christ that we are talking about, which is always present. Every time you are hearing God speak, he's reminding you of the Son. God so loved the Son, he has what? The Word, he has what? Giving the... And he gives it to you in the form of revelation, to see him, to understand him. Because that is the only way back to God. That is the only way back to that fellowship of the saints that has been from the foundation of the world. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Amen.
You might shake your body, brother. Don't sleep. Amen.
Amen.
Now, when Elijah, remember the Old Testament, because the Bible is interconnected. The Bible is what?
Interconnected.
When you read the story of Elijah, Elisha, in the Old Testament, Elijah, who was the prophet, was about to be taken up, and he asked Elisha, "What do you want from me? What can I do for you before I'm taken up?" And the response of Elisha was, "I want the double portion of your anointing." Now, if an ordinary man, if they ask you, "What do you want?" What will you ask God for?
To be a millionaire.
Plenty of money.
To be as rich and more than Solomon.
Yes. That will be the first thing that will come to a man.
Of course.
Who say, "Finally, my dream have come true." There is a God in Israel.
Oh, yes.
There is God. The first thing that comes to the mind is your projects, your dreams of money and everything that you've not completed.
Those who laugh at me don't.
Praise God. And you start imagining how you're going to deal with those people that have laughed at you and looked down on you all these years. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Some people, the next thing they step into politics. Praise God. And Elijah, the servant of God, the prophet, was not a rich man. Do you notice? He was not a rich man. At times he stayed in small rooms. At times he stayed on mountains. At times he stayed, he lived in caves. He was not a rich man. But you know what? He got whatever he wanted. When there was famine, he got the bread. When it was the wilderness, the ravens. The ravens came to what?
To feed him.
He had the power. And when you have the power, you don't abuse the power.
At all.
Hallelujah. You know, God has all the power in heaven and earth. Doesn't mean that he comes there and now he makes a house of gold and he stays inside. It's our carnal minds that, you know, our sense of nakedness that make us think that riches can cover our glory, our nakedness. All you need is the glory of God.
Amen.
To cover your nakedness. Praise God. And when you walk in the consciousness of the Son of God, knowing that all things are yours, knowing that all things have been delivered into my hands by the Father, what is greater than that? Praise God. You can have all the money and not have the power. You know that? What shall it profit a man if he gains this world and loses his soul? You lose your soul to the power of the grave, to death. You lose your soul so that you are lost out of God's realm. You lose the power. You lose everything. You lose your right, your inheritance as a son of God. Exactly the way of Esau. Esau sold his birthright for a pot of porridge. Yeah, but that is the belly is his God. Esau is the generation of those who forsake their glory in God for the glories of this world, for temporary satisfaction. You satisfy your stomach, won't you be hungry again?
After 2 hours.
That is those people who forsake their glory as sons of God for the glories of this world. So Elisha was very wise. He asked for the double portion of the anointing. He was wise. And today, that should be your desire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the condition of Elijah to Elisha was that only if you can see me. You see that scene again? He didn't tell him to go and pay tithes or you know, or to make a big church, white church, with big chairs and all those things. All these religious concepts that you had in your minds that lay burdens on you people, unnecessary burdens. Things that God didn't send you to do, you do it. You put yourself in bondage and put other people in bondage. I know many pastor friends today, they can't pay the rent of the hall that they have they've rented. Pastor friends, they tell me. Some of them are in court, cases in court. Is that what God sent you to do? No, God said, send the message. What you are seeing, send it to them for them to see. That is the will of God. Not for you to build big buildings. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If it's God's will, you don't have to sweat for it. It will be there.
Hallelujah.
You don't need to sweat. You want to sweat for it and work for that. You don't know that is your God's money. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. That's how it works. Praise God. So Elisha was told that if you can see. Do you know what Elisha saw? He saw a chariot and he saw horsemen of fire, flames of fire. You know, fire is synonymous with spirit.
Yes.
Can you hold a fire?
No way.
It's like spirit. That is, God uses it as a when you say fire, symbol of the spirit. He said he makes his angels spirit. He makes his ministers flames of fire. Who are his ministers? You. He's glorifying you into a spiritual state, a celestial state, not religion. Religion cannot take you to God. Don't be deceived. It's your ascension spiritually that makes you something inside of God. God doesn't want any good man, or he wants a spiritual man. Praise God. So what Elisha saw was actually an allegory of the body of Christ.
Oh, yeah.
He saw a chariot and many horsemen. He says, he shouted, Father, 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 the chariot of Israel and the horsemen thereof. They were all together. He was seeing the glory of God. That glory of God is a composite body. Do you know who the horsemen are? Look at the horsemen.
Amen.
Everybody's quiet. God wants you. These are things that you have forgotten about yourself. God is showing you your state, your oneness with his glory. When God appears, you appear. When you appear, God appears.
Yes.
Without you, there is no God.
Hallelujah.
And without God, there is no you.
Hallelujah.
They are one.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
So if you can see this mystery, if you can see it, you know, what happened when Elisha saw that glorious vision? The Bible says he tore his old garment. He tore the old garment. He tore it into pieces and took the garments of his master that was taken away. That old garment, the Bible calls it the old man. The old corrupt man. It's the man of the flesh. The man you walked in a mistaken identity, who has no value. That man is only worthy of death by the cross.
Amen.
Praise God. Those that have found their lives in this world must lose it. Praise God. Did you put on that AC, Samuel? Put it on, please. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Leave it. That's enough. Amen.
Amen.
Those that have found their life in this world must lose it. Now, as we see Christ, spontaneously the old man dies away. That's why you must see him. The God says that no man can see my glory and live. It's written in the Bible. No man can see me and
live.
So as you are beholding the glory of God, as you are seeing what is the mystery of Christ, there is a death of the old man. He must give way. Praise God. And you are united, because from that moment onwards, Elisha was united with the host of heaven. That is how you can get the anointing, the double portion. When he says all power in heaven and earth is given to me, because Jesus Christ, as a man, he had left everything and united with that glory.
Hallelujah.
And God wants you, as you see the mystery of the faith, the mystery of the Father and the Son, God wants you to enter into this mystery. Do you know that you are the Son? And do you know that in your ascended state, you are the Father? Do you know that? There's a silence here. Your eyes are being opened today.
Amen.
To see it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
God is giving you access back into his glory. When John saw the Alpha and the Omega, look, I've told you, all through the Bible is speaking about Christ. Christ, I am that I am, Alpha and the Omega, I am the burning bush. Everything from Genesis to Revelation is all speaking about Christ. It's speaking about the mystery of the body, mystery of the faith. Praise God. And as we are hearing these things, we are arising from our differences, and we are now being united once more consciously, because we are one body. Paul says that we are members of one another. Do you believe it?
I do.
We are members of one
another.
No matter what you think, no matter what he did to you, or what she did to you, or whatever, you are all members of one another. In love, in God.
Hallelujah.
Talk in the book of Ephesians. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 17. Are you there? I say therefore, Ephesians chapter 4 verse 17, this I say therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk in the vanities of their mind, having their understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their eyes, of their hearts. Now you can see blindness there. That means they can't see.
Okay.
They can't see. Amen?
Amen.
Who being past feeling, having given themselves over unto lasciviousness, to walk all on cleanliness and with greediness. But you have not so learned Christ. If so be that you have heard of him and have been taught by him, have you been taught by him?
Yes.
As the truth is in Jesus, that you put off concerning the former conversation, the old man who is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, that you put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Wherefore, putting away lying, speak every man truth with his neighbor, for you are what?
members one of another.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? He said we are members
of one another.
We are members of one another, brethren. Do you know the implication of this? Do you know why Paul could write this kind of message? Because Paul had seen with the eyes of the understanding of the Spirit the mystery of the body of Christ.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We all enter in by love, by oneness. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Recognizing that from the foundation of the world, we are one in God. The old pattern of thought has to be destroyed daily as we renew our mind. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If you walk as a carnal person, you cannot see this revelation. Because if I walk as a carnal person, I see the sister there as queen. I see her as somebody from Edo. A Benin woman for that matter. Amen.
Amen.
And I'll say, God forbid. Or I see that brother like, you know, I see that one as that and that one as that. And you know, you can never see this thing with a natural mind. Or say maybe the person behaves this way or the person behaves that way. You begin to judge by your natural senses. You can never see this mystery. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So God wants every man to see with the eyes. See. Recognize this mystery. This is what church is all about. We come here today to remind ourselves of this union that has been in God. This is the gateway to heaven. Jesus Christ says, no one comes to the Father except by me. You must recognize the mystery of the faith of the body of Christ. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You know, we will see beautiful things. Big, big church organizations. Big, big clappings and big, big choirs. And those things have no meaning if you are not seeing the mystery of Christ. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
It has no meaning. There is no meaning at all. It's all dead words. Listen to me, brethren. Why I'm saying this is because people have challenged me. Times without number. People have come here and they've laughed at me, they mock at me. See, even when they are leaving this church, they tell me, they enter the car and they talk all the way to where they're going and they're all laughing and mocking me. They tell me, I hear all these things. You see, but you know what Jesus Christ says? You know what he says? He says they will laugh and mock at the Son of Man. See, the Bible says that scoffers, you know what scoffers are? Mockers, scoffers, they will arise the last days. They will mock you that have the true word of God. They laugh at you. Praise God. You see, what John was told to send to the churches is a revelation of Christ. He did not see a revelation of a church order somewhere in Asia anywhere. You know, some people come here and try to tell me I should be like another church, what other people are doing. It's what God sees or shows us in the heavens that we share here. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So let us be very, very careful because the seducer, there's a seducer spirit and it's powerful in the realms of religion. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And that spirit works to dissemble, to destroy what God is doing. And what is God doing? He's gathering. He's gathering the people, what? Unto
himself.
He that does not gather with me scatters. Are you listening? He that does not gather with me scatters. And where are we being gathered? We're not being gathered into any denomination. We're not being gathered into any church banner or whatever. We're being gathered into Christ. Into that one body. That's why God says, see, all eyes shall see him. All eyes shall see him. See what is the mystery and be gathered unto him once more. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If things are getting, ask God and he will show you. Ask God, God, open my eyes to see the mystery of the faith. Hallelujah. I will round up fast with this last verse. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 8. How are you doing, sister? God bless you. Are you there?
Yes.
Ephesians chapter 3, verse 8. Unto me, who am less than the saints, less than the least of all the saints, is this grace given that I should preach unto the Gentiles what? The unsearchable riches of Christ, and to make all men, and this is the reason, and to make all men to see what is the
fellowship
of the mystery, which from the foundation of the world has been hidden God, who created all things by Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Listen to me. God created all things by
Jesus Christ.
And who is Jesus Christ?
We are.
Look at the body of Christ here.
Amen.
God created this world by you. When you hear in the book of in Genesis, let us make man. Let us, who are the us? Look at the us. Can you hear this thing in churches?
No.
You can't hear these kind of things in churches because they don't know it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
They don't know it. Hallelujah. Look at what he said. This is what he said. He was given the mandate to preach. To preach the mystery of the fellowship.
Hallelujah.
Listen, look at this, the fellowship of Amen. The saints in
Amen.
God.
Amen.
That is what the gospel is. Awaken us so that we leave the vanities of this age, to leave all the quarrels and all the bitterness and all the strife for glory, to leave all these vain things and once more unite in harmony.
Amen.
And speak with one voice.
Amen.
Amen.
That's what it's all about. Once the people begin to love one another and appreciate one another and walk in oneness, then you begin to see the power of God.
Amen.
In demonstration once more in the body of Christ. Because that power that created the heavens and the earth rests with you. This is the word of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So let us be seeing, open our eyes more and more to see, forgiving one another. Praise God. Recognizing the secret of Christ. Recognizing our oneness with the Father. Hallelujah. Seeing, because God has given us a seeing eye and a hearing ear. Amen. Let's stand up. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The seeing eye and the hearing ear. When Elisha saw that body, he was alone. He was alone. He was not with a crowd. Are we ready to walk a solitary walk with God?
Yes.
God does not walk with crowds. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He walked with 300 men to defeat the battles of the armies of the Midianites. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was only three disciples that went up to see the glorified Christ, the Alpha and the Omega. John was alone on the island when he saw the Alpha and the Omega. It's a solitary walk. It's not a walk of popularity or competition for popularity. It's that I may know him, that I may be found in him, that I may know what is the mystery of the faith. It's not showtime, baby. Brother, it's not showtime. Amen.
Amen.
It's not showtime. It's serious business. Something that will lead you into eternity. Where he says that you shall never die. You shall live forever.
Amen.
Oh, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Precious promises are ours. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, return to your first love. Remember from the heights of paradise, from where you are falling. Return to your first love. To him that overcomes, will I grant once more a passageway into my paradise, into my presence, into my glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. You are the stars on his right hand. You are the seven stars at the right hand of God, the right hand of power, the morning stars, the stars of God. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, Father, thank you.
Bless you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
God says, see, concentrate to seeing, and your ride will be smooth in this life. Everything will fall into place.
Amen.
If you have debt problems, you have problems in the outer world, you cannot, your worrying cannot solve it. Leave it at the feet of Jesus and follow the Lord in the regeneration. And he will take care of it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Lord knows how to turn around that thing for his glory.
Oh, yes.
He can turn around that situation for his glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God, Father.
Hallelujah.
Father, thank you. Because the unsearchable riches, unsearchable, you cannot search it. You cannot search the riches of Christ. It's beyond the comprehension of man. Oh, praise God, hallelujah. It's all at our disposal today. Because everything that is the Father has been handed over to us. We who are the Son. Father, thank you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Spirit of malice, competition, bitterness, hate, irritation, all these things, we keep away from them. Because we have not learned this thing from Christ. As we see a body of oneness. They speak with one language. How lovely it is when brethren dwell together in unity.